country is crying out for leadership. Leadership that can unite us. Leadership that brings us together. That's what the presidency is.
Joe Biden does not have the strength, stamina, and mental fortitude required to lead this country.
Two campaigns trying to convince voters it's their candidate who should lead the country. And the campaign commercials keep coming.
I think we can expect to see a lot of advertising in Pennsylvania. It started here early and often already.
Michael Hagan is an associate professor of political science at Temple University.
The Biden campaign is more engaged in trying to persuade people to support them. The Trump campaign is more concerned with trying to make sure that the people who do support the president get out to the polls on election day.
One recent ad from President Trump starting with the depiction of a call to 911 and using images from recent protests.
Due to defunding of the police department, we're sorry, but no one is here to take your call.
President Trump is trying to create fear and anxiety. That is not good.
He's saying, I will keep you safe, whether you like me or not, I will keep you safe.
We sat down for a virtual talk with Democratic consultant Eleanor Desi and Republican strategist Joe Watkins. Watkins, a former White House aide in the George H.W. Bush administration, says that ad that refers to defunding the police is effective.
To see that ad and to see that that there might be defunding of the police or some diminishing of the police response when you need a police officer, that's a lot enough to scare a lot of people into saying, wow, I don't like that.
Desi says it's misleading.
Defunding the police does not mean abolishing the police department.
Biden has also not backed the idea of defunding. The summer flood of ads coming as Pennsylvania is among the states where restrictions on gatherings are still in place due to the coronavirus. The cases are rising in some states.
It's uncharted territory. Everybody's trying to figure out how to connect.
In 2016, then-candidate Trump and then-Democratic nominee Hillary Clinton made numerous in-person campaign visits to Pennsylvania.
Does this raise the stakes for the ads because that's how you're reaching people right now?
I think it does. I mean, I think that by virtue of necessity, everybody's got to raise their game. And so the ads now are going to play a larger role.
Expect more to come. I'm Lauren Make, NBC 10 News. Not just those.